Hi, this is Adam Lane with Pocketnow.com. We've got a special throwback for you today. Now, this is one of HTC's first iPhone clones. You may have heard about how Apple is suing HTC about patent infringement. Now, this device came out in 2003. I bought it from a guy in Dubai because that was the only place you could get it at the time. So, come on, let's check it out. Oh, what was that? You said the iPhone wasn't released until 2007? And here it is, the HTC Himalaya. This was released in September of 2003. It's also known as the iMate Pocket PC Phone Edition. And here we've got a 3.5-inch screen. It's, you know, very large compared to many of the devices from just a few years ago. We have hardware buttons at the top. Those can be assigned to whatever application you want. Here's your speaker. You have a 5-way directional pad. Very nice feel to it with the action button in the middle. Then you have your call, send, and end buttons, as well as a microphone down here. The screen is inset, so you got a little bezel there. At the top, we have our power button, LED indicator light, infrared port. Yeah, you guys probably don't even know what that is. And a full SD card slot. Over here we've got the stylus silo. This is a very hefty stylus. Nice fit. At the bottom is your sync port. It's proprietary. And a little rubber flap covering a 2.5mm headset jack. Back when, you know, those were popular. Over here we have a reset button. And then up here we have a couple more customizable buttons. This one is a voice recorder. This is volume up and down. And this is for the camera. And on the back we have a VGA camera. This is your mirror, so you can see yourself. And this is a antenna extender. You got a little rubber thing covering that. And here's a battery cover latch. So you press the little button and that comes off. We have a battery. There's another latch to release the battery. And here's an expansion port. There was an accessory you could get to replace the battery cover that also allowed you VGA output to a projector. So if you wanted to show some PowerPoint presentations. Now, originally this came with Windows Mobile 2003, but it's since been upgraded to Windows Mobile 5. So let's take a look at that. Windows Mobile 5 introduced our soft key menus at the bottom, and we've got our start menu. You see the today screen looks pretty familiar to Windows Mobile 6 and 6.1. And you got your date and everything, calendar. That's all customizable, just as it always was. We have our start menu. Same as everything. Camera. See how that works. Just fine. And File Explorer, of course. You can see how quick this is. Pretty easy to browse. And let's just, where do we have? We got a video here. Check out that video quality. Really nice, actually. You gotta consider that this phone was made during a time when Apple was making iPods with grayscale screens and little hardware clicker buttons. And we've got a phone with really nice, smooth video quality. In addition, well, this is Windows Media Player, so of course it syncs with your desktop computer for MP3 files. And you got your big SD slot, so plenty of music. We've also got Internet Explorer. If I can press it. So you got a full HTML browser. Again, at a time when nothing else was really capable of doing this. You've got notes, of course, voice recording, exchange push syncing, tasks, PowerPoint. Office Mobile looks pretty much the same as it always has. Games, Bubble Breaker and Solitaire. Hooray! Messaging. Of course, we got Outlook. Calendar. And there's the phone dialer. Now this was actually the first Pocket PC phone that doesn't have an antenna sticking out. It's an internal antenna. It was also the first Pocket PC phone with Bluetooth support. You see my Bluetooth light blinking over here. So that meant you could use a Bluetooth headset. And you could also use a Bluetooth GPS. So you could get your GPS navigation instructions using any of the, you know, half dozen GPS programs that were around at the time. So you could hear your voice prompting navigation instructions and have your Bluetooth headset for making phone calls while also listening to music through Windows Media Player all at the same time, you know, back in 2003. Here's another thing I want to show you for the Himalaya. This is the dock. That's what it came with. And this goes, plugs into USB. And we have a nice little cradle for it. But we also have a battery charger. So there's the cradle. And we also have a microphone for speaker. This is a little light indicator for the secondary battery for when that's charging. So you could, you know, use up your battery here, swap it into the fresh battery really easily. Really a great, innovative Pocket PC phone from 2003. That's it for now.